It was an interesting morning for me yesterday. My dogs walked in on me masturbating. You know, I don't know if that's normal for you. It's not normal for me. The dogs walking in on me. I mean, yeah, interesting. Hey guys, what do you think? You know, I decided to rip out this old chain link fence so that it could be uniform, the yard. And a lot of this bullshit shrubbery was suffocating a couple saplings. There's a sapling over here. It's not really more of a sapling. I guess it's an established tree now. Here it is. And then there's this other tree. You know, and all this fucking bullshit vegetation just sucks up moisture that the trees could benefit from. Anyways, guys, I'm doing a lot of shit. It was awful there, guys, for a little while. No weed, no THC. I hit that 72-hour threshold, guys, where my cannabinoid receptors had reset. But lo and behold, guys, I've asked somebody at work straight up if they smoke weed. And the guy said yes. Immediately followed that question with, "Would you like to smoke?" Which I instantaneously said, "Of course." And I was able to buy off everything he had on him, guys. You know, that's just always good to have cash on hand. And now I've remedied my situation, guys. I was also able to get one of these new THC pens that's rechargeable. It's pretty interesting, pretty cool. I'll show it to you guys later. But I hit that, and man, I gotta tell you, night and day, it's like drinking a pot of coffee, guys. So I just came out here to rip out this bullshit fence, and I've been tearing out the chain link in sections. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna use them, the cut up pieces of chain link after I burn away a lot of this fucking bullshit thorn on there, and I'm gonna use that to like reinforce some concrete molds and stuff. I've been doing a lot of thinking, guys. I've been doing a lot of visualization, so even though I don't put out very many videos, I try to really only give you guys a day out of my week. I'm pretty selfish like that, guys. Having the three dogs is actually really easy, guys. In case you guys were wondering, if it's easier to have one dog versus three dogs, guys, it's fucking easier to have three dogs than one dog if they all get along, because aside from the learning curves, because there's going to be some learning curves everywhere. You know, with meal time and just getting adjusted to the humans and everything, guys. So we're past that, all that with Cobra. Where's Cobra? Come here, Cobra. Come make an appearance. He's pretty good. Here he comes. And guys, he's almost as big as Bingo now. Come here, Cobra. If you guys remember, he was definitely shorter than Bingo, and now he's almost caught up to him. And Gracie's here too. Gracie, come here, girl. Come here. So we have Gracie, Bingo, and Cobra. And Cobra's a great doggy. So, what else? Guys, I got the lower and the upper control arms, the adjustable ones from Rusty's. I have been waiting on them. So that's $500 there for both lowers and uppers. And it's breaking dawn right now, guys. It's like 5:30 in the morning. So I'll probably burn a lot of this shit up, and I'll show you guys what it looks like later. And I did call 811, so the person's gonna be coming by today to mark up a lot of some stuff in the front. I'm not gonna do anything. I just wanted to know where everything is. Oh, guys, it was so crazy. So fucking crazy. My heart dropped, guys. I got into flight mode, like, jumped in the fucking car. My phone was actually right here, guys. I had, I went to go to the gas station to get some fucking gas. And I placed the gas can right when I got here, guys. I put 5 gallons. Man, I knew I shouldn't have smoked before I fucking went, guys, because I ended up spilling some gas anyways while I was there. So I came home and I put that there, and I jumped in the XC90 because I got the battery charging in the back right now, and I need to move it because the 811 people are going to come mark up this driveway here on the left. And guys, so I carry all my debit cards and my license and everything in my phone. It was just so crazy. I was like, could I have been that fucking stupid to leave my phone on top of the car? And I was like, yeah, I could have right then, that moment. And oh my Lord, guys. I was just, everything was running through my head. I was like, how am I gonna fucking cancel everything? I do everything on my phone. And oh man, it was just, thank goodness. You know, when I was driving home, and no luck at the gas station, guys, this is right down the corner, like a mile. I was just like, it's gotta be in the Volvo. It's gotta be in the Volvo. Fucking, it was in the Volvo, guys. Ah, shit, man. Let me show you what I have going on here. I actually have been sitting on a lot of different types of pavers. We've just been collecting them over the years. And what my dad had all right here was just carpet. All this carpet right here, I just fucking unrolled it earlier all over again. And I'll show you. It's like 9 a.m. now, guys. And oh man, my heart is racing, guys. I can't believe I was going so fast on the road. Oh shit, man. Yeah, that was just crazy. That was fucking nuts, guys. All right, so you know, I took all the fencing down. Now I'm gonna leave these here. I'm gonna remove these top caps, and these are still straight and strong, and there's 4 of them that are uniform. The last one's probably gonna go. I can keep it, I don't know, but I'm thinking I'm just gonna make some custom tiki torches, tiki torch heads for them, guys, and it'll look good. Oh, so there's obviously a depression here. I'm gonna remove this siding. You see this metal siding, guys? This is like some homemade edging that my pop made from scrap. But anyways, there's probably like, you know, a space for a good foot of dirt right there, guys. And I have plenty of dirt. My dad's been actually been wanting me to fucking put all this dirt right here that's on the side and add it to the mound. So I'm gonna fill it in over there, and that should take care of all that, guys. And all this dirt is just dirt that I've removed from the driveway to improve the grade for like drainage and shit. And oh, what else, guys? You know, I have been sitting on this 5-gallon bucket of paint for a while, for like almost a year now, and I had bought it for the house next door. And I thought it was too light of a color to use on this house, but it's not. And I think because I was going to go ahead and get a 5-gallon bucket of Bear Marquee. That shit's expensive, like $245, you know, for one bucket. But I already have a bucket, guys, so I might as well use it, right? That's the law of use, you know. Can't be hoarding up fucking paint, guys. So you see how I ran out of paint, guys, this dark blue paint. I ran out of paint when I was doing this side. And so I just filled it in with some baby blue paint. And I can't believe I never fixed it, guys. But I'm going to fucking fix it, you know. So just get a good look at it, guys. And I'm going to paint it with this other paint that I have. And I'm just waiting for Rusty's to get here. I'll show you some upper control arms. Well, I have the lower control arms right here, but I'm waiting on the upper control arms. And I did order some shit from Clayton Off-Road, guys. So It wasn't all Rusty's. I really like the shackles from Clayton Off-Road. I'll show those to you. But these are the fucking XJ Jeep Comanche adjustable lower control arms. And you see, I have like three or four threads in there. I just wanted to give you guys a look at how much length of adjustment you get on these. So that's really incredible. So yeah, planning on, well, I don't know if I'm gonna paint today. I have to fucking clean that wall. I have to pressure wash it. I don't have a pressure washer, but I'm gonna hit it with the nozzle on the hose. And I have a spray gun. My dad had a spray system here. I don't know if he still has it, because I remember he told me he got on to me because I never cleaned it out after I painted. I'm sure I did clean it out a few times, but then on the last time I probably just got lazy and didn't do it, and then probably gunked it up. So I don't know if it's still here and if it's still usable, but I don't mind using a brush, but we'll find out. And let me show you the paint. I'll just show you the color that I'm talking about. And my dad actually went on vacation again, so that's kind of the reason why I'm doing all of this, because it's just always better to ask for forgiveness and permission, right, guys? You've heard that before. So that's what I have. I might as well use it, right? I think I paid like, I don't know how much I paid for this, around 150 at least, maybe more like 170. But that's the color right there, guys. So it's kind of like a grayish green. So we're gonna use that on the side of the house. And if I like it, I'll extend it all over. Now I do have to clean up some of the edging of the brick on this house, because I did overspray. And so I wanna clean the paint off. I'll show you guys what I'm talking about. A lot of projects, guys. I know everyone always says you got to tackle one project at a time. And I agree that is efficient, but I'm just not like that, guys. You see how I have a lot of overspray? Yeah, so I got to clean that up. I don't know how I'm going to clean that. I mean, I have a bunch of acetone. I could try it with that. But and then my dad wanted to do some sort of glaze, some sort of sealer. He never did it, so we're going to do it. But yeah, look at this shit, guys. So much carpet right there. And, you know, I called 811 and there was like a fucking interrogation with that lady on there. I was like, geez, lady, I was just, you know, I want to find out where everything is so I can make some plans. You know, for like just landscaping, I want to plant a tree, some more trees, some evergreen trees up front. And so I just wanted to know where everything was. But you see the way this is, guys? I could actually just like bevel it out, you know, like to where I make it level, and then I can just start adding like aggregate. And so I don't really need to go down, because all this dirt right here has been already driven over and compacted, and it's fine. It is totally fine. So that's what we're gonna do here. And I'll show you the stone that I'm talking about. Now, I did order some molds from Kiev. Yeah, it's amazing. They have a war going on over there, and they're still shipping out product, which is great. And so these molds that I got, I'll show those to you guys later. They're inside in the kitchen. But you get like six for like 70 bucks. But they're supposed to be very hardy. But they leave an amazing texture. This is very realistic to rock. But these are the fucking pavers, guys. So we have a lot of these pavers. Let's get a look. It's not... It's like a straight edge, and then it has like a rough surface there. But from the top, if you have them buried, it's just a rectangle. So it's going to be easy. And actually, guys, we never have all those pavers because I actually built like a bed platform out of it. It was very like medieval, fucking rough, manly bed. But yeah, I would always stub my toes. Girls would, my girlfriend would always stub her toes on it and hit her shin. She hated it. But it was fucking rock solid, guys. Oh, and I'm also going to be sorting out, I'm going to be making some cuts on this exhaust for the XC90. So that's what I'm doing. And I'm going to clean up this fucking pitman arm. Drop pitman arm, guys. I'm going to clean this shit. And then I'm going to spray paint it. So we still have a little bit to go on this battery. Man, I was so tired. I started watching the Black Sails, you know, the pirate show. And now I'm making burgers, guys. These are bison burgers. I cut them in half so that I can make sliders and stuff. You know what I'm saying? What about you guys? What kind of burgers do you guys like? I'm using these buns right here. They're so good. Some ketchup. Just some ketchup, mayonnaise. No cheese on them, you know. A tomato. You want some Cobra? You can have some. This is so funny. All the dogs, they always do this. Every dog, like every puppy that we get, they always chill under this table. And the one Cobra's not gonna be able to fit in that little nook for much longer. Watch, he's gonna blow up. This guy's gonna blow up. And guys, these are the burgers. So these are buffalo burgers, guys, and they're really good. I get them at Aldi. There's like four of them in a, no. Yeah, there's four of them in a pack and they're $10. And that might be really expensive for some people, but they're so fucking good, guys. They really are worth it. And I got some other burgers inside in the freezer too. This year I started eating a lot of burgers, so it's not bad, guys. It's better than eating out. You know what I'm saying? Better than eating out.
While I was inside eating, I saw a car pull up, but I didn't think that was the A11 person. But yeah, they came in and they're already marked. I only see yellow, and so I think this is just the gas. I think I only have to worry about the gas, which is what I thought was all right here. Anyways, since we have overhead electricity or overhead drop, although I want to say there is a water line here. I do want to say there's a water line, so maybe there's more than one person that comes. That's the gas line. That's just gas, Cobra, don't worry. You know what the best anti-theft system, you know what the best anti-theft alarm, guys? Take your fucking battery out of the car. And you don't have to worry about anybody breaking your shit. Maybe they'll break it, but they won't take off with it. Yeah, I've been paranoid lately. I mean, guys, they don't fucking make these, guys. A V8 all-wheel drive Volvo. Fucking rare, guys. Fucking rare. Damn it, Cobra, where was this? Guess it doesn't matter. I'm gonna hand dig and see where that is. Might be time to replace these. Go get this battery. See, what's this? This looks like some sort of drain. We'll investigate that later. Hey! Nice little dirt patch, you guys. The guy's dogs have been tearing up this grass, which is fine, you know, it doesn't matter. that's good enough. Duracell. I should have gone with the larger battery, but I went with the smaller one.
If you stay till the end of the video, or whatever, I mean, you could skip to the end of the video, but I was just gonna say, is I'm actually going to share some of my self-talk with you guys if you care. And it will be very beneficial if you've never heard any of these phrases before. They'll be worth writing down or just, you know, rewatching and so until you memorize them. But what I wanted to show you was what I was talking about was this cake pen here. Now, these aren't new, right? There's plenty of these on the market, but this is all self-contained. It's got 1 gram, but look, it has a charging port in there. So it's kind of strange for me. I never seen one like this, but when I hit this thing, it's going to give me so much energy, guys. It's just going to like melt my brain. I can't explain it. This is a sativa. But yeah, I'm going to siphon some gas. Well, not siphon some gas from the jug to the Volvo. Because I'm not supposed to drive it on the road. So it's getting almost to E. And I expect that within a couple months, I'll go ahead and get the title and get it registered. But in the meantime, I just wanted to fill it up. So whenever I do get it road legal, it's got a full tank ready for me, you know? I bought the shotgun, Gracie. Yeah, Gracie, she likes to medicate with me. She loves it. And I actually baptized a cobra. So Cobra's has already had a couple little sessions. Isn't he just adorable? Oh yeah, that's good stuff, guys. Good stuff. You wanna see how we do this? This is how we do it. Man, I'm so lucky. Everything would have gotten ruined, guys, if I would have left my phone on top of the car at the gas station. That would have been the end of the YouTube channel, guys. There would have been no fucking YouTube channel. So just realize that, guys. So I've used this thing once before. It's really easy, guys. Guys, this shit right here costs like $6. Order it online. Go to AutoZone. I think I got this one at Advanced Auto Parts. And there's 5 gallons in here, guys, of 93 octane. This shit was expensive. I paid $60, guys. I put 5 gallons in the Accord. Not that it needed it, but now it's almost full. And I put 5 gallons in here, guys. Fucking cost me $58. See that, guys? And all I have to do is just pump it. What the heck? Oh, I just lost the little collar. It went in there, but it doesn't matter. Hey, what's going on here? There we go. Oh, if I punch it too much, it'll squirt. Yeah, guys, so, you know, I opened up this video with a remark about masturbating, you know? I know that probably made some people cringe or roll their eyes. Let me explain, actually. That's one of life's greatest mysteries, guys. That's one of man's most thought of questions, really, when you think about morality. You know, we all think we have some level of morality. And so we've all had those thoughts like, is masturbation, is it safe? Is it beneficial? You know, and then you have this other side of it, sexual transmutation, guys, where you take up your sexual energy, your sexual frustration, your chi, whatever the fuck you want to call it, your mojo, and you channel it into something productive. And then when you when you're overcome with that sexual urge and you just don't touch yourself and you proceed to think your way out of that erection, not that there's anything vile or sinful about having an erection, right, guys? That's if you can have an erection, that's good blood flow, guys. I'm 35. I've never taken any sort of Viagra or anything like that. I think I heard like a old wives tale, like it makes you go blind or something. But I always knew that, like, once you start on something, because I was always dependent on weed, guys. So I never wanted to get addicted to anything else in my life. And so I imagine that those erectile dysfunction dick aid pills are like that. You know, maybe they give you a really hard, rock solid erection, but then maybe you just feel like you can never have sex or perform at your best without that pill, guys. And so I don't know what it's like to take a pill, you know, guys. But I will say that, like, I have morning wood all the time, guys. Very bad in the morning. And why am I telling you that? Because that is an easy way to determine if you have a healthy level of testosterone. You may not think, like, you may, a lot of people associate like having a beard, a face full beard, that signifies high testosterone. But then, you know, you have people that have like heavy facial hair and they have like, and then they're bald up top, you know? So like, I don't understand all the hormone, how it regulates hair growth and everything, guys. But, you cannot fucking tell by just looking at someone, guys. We're all built differently, and sometimes you just be surprised who has the highest testosterone. You know, I listen to Dan Pena sometimes, and that motherfucker brags and boasts that he has like 700% the average testosterone. I mean, that's just not possible. Not without a supplementation of external testosterone, but... Yeah, you know, it's crazy testosterone, guys, you know. Some women will take it to balance themselves out. That's one thing that I've always been very, that I've always thought, we're going to go back to the masturbation here in a minute. But I've always put a lot of thought into, like, if I was ever going to procreate and have children, I would definitely want to try with a partner that had not been on birth control. You know, guys, because when women are put on birth control here in America from like when they're 15 and on, that just fucks up with their whole body, guys. Who knows what that really does, you know? You're messing with the greatest creation on earth, you know? When you're messing with your body, you're messing with the greatest creation on earth because you are the most important person in your world. And so when you fucking voluntarily... open up yourself, like with these vaccines, guys. You put yourself at so much risk. But anyways, yeah. So I don't know. Could all that birth control, and then and many partners or whatever, guys? Could that lead to like children having autism or like having handicaps, guys? I don't know. I don't know. It could, you know. I feel like there's definitely some correlation there. But yeah, guys, I've also always thought about that. Like, what would I do if I had a child that was a handicap? You know, because what do you do when it's an animal, guys? You put it out of its misery, right? You look ahead, but some people just they don't look at it like that when it's a kid. And so, I mean, you can make another kid. I mean, I just don't know, guys. I'm not talking out of turn there, guys. This is some hypothetical babble. But the masturbation. Yeah, guys, the masturbation, like, because I don't know you, I find it myself sometimes, guys, you know, I don't have a woman to sheathe my sword close to me, guys, because I'm always working isolated in odd hours. I just don't have a network, and that's fine right now. But hey, guys, if I had never had sex, yeah, I'd drive myself crazy. Thankfully, you know, I've had quite a bit of sex It's some quite various partners, different types of women, guys, in my 20s and whatnot. But God, it's been a very dry 30s, I'll tell you that. I know it's going to be fucking wet 40s, 50s, and 60s, and looking onwards, I'm just going to have massive, copious, amazing lovers. And you see how I'm just kind of professing my future there? Because that's what I want, guys. I actually do want a lot of sex out of life, but with the right partners. You know, I don't want fucking dirty people. Because I just don't want to catch anything. I think that's part of the reason that why I do go to masturbating is because it's safe. You know, I don't waste energy on going out trying to find somebody who probably isn't good for me to begin with. And then I, you know, problems, attachment, whatnot. And it's not like, you know, when guys, we don't really bring a lot of shit to the relationships, guys, right? Because usually once we get into a relationship, whatever kind of relationship you want to call it, odds are you probably have had a lot of time to yourself to get yourself together or whatnot, you know. But women just go around the fucking carousel. What do they call it? The CC, the cock carousel. But not all women, right? Not all women. And so that's where guys want to go for younger girls, right? Because they know that, hey, younger girls have not been tarnished as much. And, you know, and so that's why guys go for younger girls or younger women than them usually. But yeah, the masturbation, guys, you know, I don't know what the fucking big taboo about it is. It's like so openly pushed onto women, you know. Fucking women got all those fucking crazy ass toys. And then, you know, men, guys, we just have our imagination in our hand. What's the big deal? So, yeah. Oh, and like fucking, I remember like 10 years ago, I was reading an article. Where it said, like, if men masturbate a lot between their 25 and 35, then they're very likely to develop, like, prostate cancer or something like that. And then I read another article where it's like, if you don't masturbate, you'll develop prostate cancer. So it's like, no one fucking knows, guys. No one really fucking knows anything. And no one really still to this day understands, like, understand sperm, guys. Sperm is still really to this day so fucking mysterious. Like, we know that that it's a chemical reaction. We know that when it comes in contact with embryos, you know, and the environment is not too hospitable, guys. So, you know, life will emerge. We fucking know that, guys. But aside from like the properties that like sperm can affect your thinking and like your mental power, I think that's another thing too, because like well, it's really all about how you masturbate. You could masturbate in a very healthy way, and then you could fucking take it to a very obsessive, detrimental, like negative way that just leaves you traumatized because you're fucking seeing all sorts of shit you're not supposed to be seeing, you know. So rather than, you know, just like shutting off your eyes and just like touching yourself and experiencing like your sensation and whatnot, guys. So it's, yeah, masturbation is just a whole nother world, guys. And, you know, personally myself, I can't do it a whole lot, guys. My whole life is with everything. It's like valleys and peaks, guys, you know, and the landscape is sometimes, you just don't know, like, it could be like Kansas Hills, and then it could be like all of a sudden you see the base of Mount Everest, but you can't see the top because there's just clouds. And like, that's just that could be like a sexual urge phase, guys, where you just like masturbate compulsively, and then you come back down normal to like you know, just a normal mountain range, you know, high and low. And is what I'm saying even fucking make sense? Probably not, right? Probably these fucking gas fumes are affecting my thinking. But yeah, guys, masturbation. I have found that like sometimes if you start thinking like if you say you're trying not to masturbate, not to give in, and then you're trying to do all these things, but all you can do is think about not masturbating, then just go ahead and fucking masturbate, because after that your mind will be clear, and then you can get to work and bust out some shit. And so I've actually found out too, if you're feeling like really, really tired, and you'd, sometimes masturbation will fucking wake you up. So listen, guys, that's all I'm gonna fucking say about masturbating. I'm not a doctor, okay? Should you do it? Should you not do it? Just listen to your body, guys. But I will say this, guys. If you intend to be a good lover, you gotta have a strong member. And if you don't use it, you're gonna lose it. So sometimes just masturbating is really healthy, just to regulate blood flow. Because when you think about it, it's like you're really flushing your system. Bear with me, guys. Hold on, the trucks. So your body is like a closed system, right? And like something happens when you get a full-on hard erection, like valves close all over your body, so that the pressure is regulated down to between your legs, guys. And so like after you have a release and you're done, you know, because a lot of, I don't know about you, but a lot of times, like, we can just keep going, you know, release a few moments, and then you can get an erection right back. But when you're done, all that blood is going to have to rush back to your head and stuff. And that's what I'm talking about. Like, that type of exchange, that type of exchange will help keep your blood and your capillaries and your brain and everything, guys, flowing. And it hell, it could minimize strokes, you know? I don't know. That's just some food for thought, you know? What do you think, right? Because, gosh, everything's physics and science when you think about it. Anyways, I'm almost done doing this, guys. I'm not going to bore you with any more of this bullshit talk. I just wanted to explain myself to you. And maybe if you've been feeling guilty, you don't have to feel guilty. And just remember, guys, so many people are out there fucking ruining their lives. And not just their lives. Fuck people that want to ruin their own lives, right? They can go to jail. But I'm saying people out there ruining other people's lives, guys. People can go out there and attack your sister, your cousin, you know, who knows, guys, because they fucking can't control themselves. And so that's where masturbation is healthy. Because, you're just loving on yourself. Anyways, see ya.
Good morning.
Good morning. Good morning. I swear my dad probably never heard of Jim Rohn or Zig Ziglar, but fucking A, guys. Growing up, I swear I lived with Zig Ziglar because that's how jovial my dad was all the fucking time. All the fucking time, so jovial. I can never understand how someone so sober all the time could have such a grand time all the time. Maybe one day I'll find out
what that was like. I haven't many times in my walk with the Lord feel despondent and overwhelmed.
Is that what we want? That's what we want. I don't know how this equalizer works. Anyways, I got some shit going on today, guys. I gotta add in a little extra segment. This is only 12 feet. It's about all I need for that little corner. Anyways, fuck, man. It's 9 o'clock. I gotta go into work early today, 2 hours earlier, which is okay because that's just the job getting its time back. Sometimes I'm 2 hours late to work. And so, I don't know if I told y'all guys, I was telling y'all about this tape. It worked good, but it started to give, but it's still holding. Is it worth the $7? Yeah, it'll get you out of a pinch. It's good for all sorts of stuff. I gotta water the trees and everything. try to do. I meant to do this earlier, but I know what you guys are thinking. You can't fucking water when the sun's out. Yeah, you can. It's just not smart to get the top all wet. But you can fucking water the ground, let the water soak in. So I don't know if you guys can tell, I removed all the shrubbery, all the foliage, all the bullshit. I did that all this morning. I got home from work. I'm gonna take out the edging. I'm just not gonna do it yet because I think it is anchored in with some spikes. But I wanted to keep it in to hold this little bit of dirt before I start pouring in all this excess rough aggregate dirt shit that we have over here accumulating. So all this is gonna go in there. All that is gonna fit in there. And some of this, I will probably need to get some of that too to level it out. And that's great. What do you guys think? You guys like this wall? It looks nice and clean. I tell you what, I'm for sure gonna be able to notice a decrease in the mosquitoes because all this environment right here, this was just a perfect environment for mosquitoes. And now there's no environment here for those fucking critters and shit. Man, it was nerve-wracking scooping all this shit up. I saw so many fucking hairy-ass spiders, but, you know, try not to live in fear. I did fucking buy a paint gun. I didn't even look for one here. It was just easier to just find one online. I found a good deal. I found a 40% coupon on Amazon. Oh, here, guys. I wanted to show y'all. These are the fucking shackles. They cost $150 from Clayton Off-Road. And each dot here is going to give you between 1.5 inches and 2 inches of adjustment. Hold on, guys. I got to... I got a little system where I water everything. And I've been pouring all this water into this fountain. And I see a lot of squirrels and bees and birds take advantage of it. And the dogs get a kick out of drinking water out of here too. Cobra definitely loves drinking water out of there. I'll show you here in a second. Oh man, I was feeling so tired. I had to just get my ass up and come out here. I haven't even smoked yet. But I could easily have just slept the whole day away, which I still need to sleep. Come on, guys, let's drink some water. Come on. Get some water, Gracie. Gracie, drink some water. See, I put those little stones there for Bingo to get the picture, but he's not catching on. Gracie, come on. See, Bingo's just too short. He can't reach it. Come on. Right here. Get up here, Cobra. Get up here, Cobra. You thirsty, Gracie? Come on. Bingo, I've showed you this numerous times. Come here, Bingo. I'm gonna help you out, Bingo. Come here, Bingo. Come here, buddy. Come on. Can you sit for me? If I get him to sit, it's a good moment for me to grab him. Can you sit? Sit. Bingo. Sit. Okay, he doesn't want to sit right now, guys. Usually he's very obedient. Come here, buddy. I'm gonna show you what to do. You're just gonna get up here. There you go. Sooner or later, he'll catch on. Cobra. Get up here, Cobra. Come on. Come on, Cobra. So much for that grass that was all growing here, guys. It's all fucking gone now. This shit's a fucking sandbox. So guys, I don't know if I told y'all, I remember I got pissed off at my dad because he cut a tree out in the front and then I took it out on one of these. There was one here, guys, a big sapling that was taller than me. And I twisted it up in a knot because I couldn't fucking break it. It was so fucking strong. I was drunk when I did this too. Anyways, that ended up dying off, and this is a new sprout that sprouted off that same root system. So now this oak tree is here. It's meant to stay. I'm gonna build a border around it with some rocks. Just a little story on that tree. That tree is gonna outlive me. All this right here is crushed pecans, guys. Crushed pecans from the pecan trees here. And my dad crushed all these pecans. He just fucking spends a lot of the winter just chilling, watching TV, crushing pecans. I'm just like, I didn't know what he did with all the shells until I saw that he makes his own mulch out of it. That's pretty smart, right? Yeah, I'm gonna finish showing you guys the Rusty's control arms. They came in, the upper pair came in yesterday. So I'll show you that here in a second.
This is an almost done.
Okay, guys, so this is the lower control arm, and it has this vent. So this is the way it's going to be oriented with this adjustment joint towards the front. And here, guys, we have the upper. Same adjustment rubber bushing. The rubber bushing on that on these is fixed on this side, but yeah, guys, this shit is fucking so beefy. I'll show you a comparison to the fucking stock. See this, guys? It's a replacement for that greasy ass shit right here. Give you a better look. So if you can visualize what all this is gonna look like, this is all gonna look really nice. I told my dad I'd try to have this done for him by the time he got back from vacation. But that's the upper control arm we're gonna replace. This is the fucking brake line tube kit that I bought. almost got a different one that was cheaper that would only do a single flare. Apparently that's not what you want, so a double flare is the minimum as far as safety goes. I've never used this before, guys. I've never used one of these, so it's gonna be interesting. So yeah, I'm just gonna take the fucking bolt cutters and cut the line. And fuck, I need to go and get a new thread nut deal. But yeah, we'll do all that, guys. Gotta hold it in as long as you can. Oh shit, guys. My brain is melting right now in a good way. Another of life's greatest questions for me personally is, am I ever going to get my shit together? Am I ever really going to stop and freely give up weed, guys? I don't know, man. I just can't fucking rationalize how boring life would be without it. And I don't always need to be high, guys. Just simply just being able to know that I have weed, you know, within reach, or that I can, you know, fucking smoke whenever I decide to, then I just feel better. But when you don't fucking have access to it, or you can't get it, and it's like the only thing that you like to dabble with, man, I gotta tell you, man, it's fucking crazy. You can't imagine what it's like. So I don't know if I'm always gonna live here in Texas, guys. I might have to fucking go somewhere where you can grow your own shit legally. But you know what? Maybe Texas will get their shit together, guys, and reform the laws. What do you guys think of the Belgian Malinois puppy? He's a Belgian Malinois. Fuck, guys, I don't know what he's gonna be like when he gets big. He's already a tough puppy. What are you doing, Cobra? Yeah, I feel like if we had a pool, he would always be in the pool. Once we get in the pool, Cobra's always gonna be in the pool. You having fun, little dude? That whole area is new to Gracie. She's just been tripping out, smelling it all over. Well, I stayed out here in 3 hours. It's almost 100 degrees out. I believe, got enough dirt here. I did fucking manage to clear this out, and that just makes me feel really good, you know. It just gives me a little bit of a boost, because I know this Jeep Comanche project is taking so long And that's why I have all the little things in the meantime to keep me occupied. And so every little thing that I accomplish, that just kind of sets me up for all the big things. But anyways, this is good, guys, that I cleared all this dirt out. Probably can't see right here, but it's nice. I even moved this this wood rack was buried under all that dirt. But I'll come out here later before I go to work. I definitely need to get some sleep and kind of mash all this dirt in. I already did this other half over here. And I'm not gonna go all the way to the lip because I'm gonna get a truckload of rock, river rock, once I get the Jeep Comanche sorted. I went to Home Depot yesterday and bought a bunch of the damn weed fabric. Guys, that shit was, that's not expensive, but so far it is pretty pricey stuff. And I just finished up tearing up all the roots out near that gas, whatever you call that thing, gas station. There is a bunch of bamboo here. I was able to salvage some of it, guys, and I'm gonna try to plant it in the back. We'll see if it takes root. Bamboo is really finicky. So I have it set up right there, kind of hydrating the roots until I get the soil ready. I need to figure out where I'm gonna put them. But here you can see I've been cleaning it up, all the organic matter some. I have to do this side of the fence. And then I'm gonna take that blue tool, and it has a pretty good blade on it, and I'm gonna kind of chop some high areas off before I start just putting all the fabric down and laying some sand maybe, and then some 3/4 inch gravel. But this is the bamboo I pulled out. This is a little one. This is another more substantial one that's probably more promising, but doesn't hurt to try. There's another one. And so I've been doing a lot of reading on trees, and apparently I've been watering them wrong. You're not supposed to water them right at the trunk. That's they get trunk rot that way. So I've been trying to dry them out and make sure the root flare is at the proper depth. But yeah, I think I'm gonna put the bamboo here. And then if it takes root, it theoretically will just run all along the fence line. And I was contemplating putting it right over here, but there's really no need. There's so much shit right here, wouldn't really be able to get that tall. Even right here, it probably wouldn't. So come to think about it, now I think we're just gonna have to run it alongside this wall over here. So I'll probably plant it right here in this little hump of dirt. I'm just gonna water this really good, and this is a good spot to just keep saturated, and then it should send runners all the way down, as well as all the way down right here. So actually that is a really good place to put them. So I will do that. And as you see, I did take a chunk out of that hill and got rid of all the dirt right here. And I think I can take off a little bit more dirt too. My nephew came in town. He is the son, the only son that my older brother had, that died in Iraq when he was 20. Didn't even meet his son, cause he was in country the whole time. But he drives his jacked up Ford. A pretty cool big truck. It dwarfs this fucking Jeep. I know that's for sure. Oh, guys, let me fucking show you. I went to Aldi and I went to Home Depot. This is the rock that I got. So here's two bags. There's another bag right there. And then I got another bag over there. But yeah, I spent a lot of money on hoses. I just decided to just redo all the hoses. I was thinking of starting up a business idea. Just starting like a nursery back here in the meantime before I get the pool in, you know, maybe that will generate some income. And if not, at least allow me to have plenty of stock plants to plant around in the landscape here. So that's good. I'm going to dabble in with the green thumb. And I picked up this hose here at Aldi. It's a 50 foot. Got it for 20 bucks. Then I went to Home Depot and got this. This was also 20 bucks. It's 10 foot. But I got it so that I could hook it up to this old box. And in here I replaced... this thing was still good, this seal here. So I don't know how old this unit is, but I decided to save it. And I just put two 50-inch hoses there. So I got 100 feet right here. So I pretty much set, guys, for the front and the back on hoses. So that's what we have going on. And I'm going to try to excavate all this grass out of here. It turns out that for the first 3 years, a sapling or whatever kind of tree or fruit tree, whatever you're growing, you don't fucking want it competing with any grass around it. So since we can't water it here at the trunk anymore, I'm going to have to put some mulch down and some rocks or something and just water it out on the perimeter, because that's how really the root system grows out. And so we're going to do that. That's on the list. And I'm also going to paint this. I got the painting machine in the mail. I'm going to show that to you guys here in a second. As well as I got the projector screen. I got this awesome projector screen that comes all self-contained in a tripod. And I'm going to bust out the fucking Nintendo for the first time. And I'm going to play some fucking Nintendo, some Contra. So stay tuned, guys. This right here will put you to sleep if you're not careful. Guess what, guys? Guess what this is? Look at this. Look at that shit, guys. These are some of the pools I was looking at, some pool designs. I just like a really classy, rectangular. I think because I'm going to do it myself, it's probably the most easy way to make it is if it's just a simple design. Anyways, this is a neat look. I think I only paid like less than $10 for this book. But that's not what I'm showing you guys. This is what I'm showing you. This is what I wanted to show you guys. This fucking projector screen that I just got. I got it on Amazon, guys. Amazon for like 80 bucks, guys. I got this fucking thing for like $85. That's right. My tax was like 93 bucks. Well, let's go ahead and fucking open it. Oh, all this is, this is the weed fabric I'm gonna lay down. This is the one I went with. I don't even know if this is woven or non-woven. I don't know. Anyways, Let's open this up, guys. I'm gonna open it up. I'm not gonna bore you. This video is already long enough. This thing is so fucking cool. It even came with the fucking HDMI cord. But I knew that the controllers were so short that I was gonna have to get a long HDMI. So I already had one set aside for it. But guys, I even fucking ordered a wireless controller. That's right, I ordered a wireless. Look at this shit. Isn't this fucking crazy to see blue light, a power bank? I actually think I can run the fucking whole unit off of the power bank. And you see, I was gonna set up the projector. It comes fucking straight out of the box, just like that, guys. Straight out of the box. All you do is just collapse the screen and lean it, and then the legs will collapse like an umbrella, and it all slides in the box, guys. It's fucking trippy. I didn't have to do anything but unwrap it. Seriously. And I was gonna put it up outside just to have me and my nephew play with it, but it's fucking hot as shit out there, and I knew I wanted the AC inside for him to play in, and I knew that the projector would just run better inside, and you know, bugs would just not fucking we wouldn't get stung by any mosquitoes. But anyways, guys, so I set it up here in the kitchen for now. This is just for tonight, just to play around with it and get this out of the way. Let me get this out of the way. This is the receiver for the wireless controller, and you see it matches up with the stock one. So I'll put that in there. Guys, see, I already have the projector up here, guys. I have the projector. Interesting story behind that painting, guys. My fucking girlfriend used to hate this painting, guys. She wanted me to throw it away and burn it. And this is like one of the only things that I didn't fucking sell off when times got rough. And isn't this just a badass painting? If you spend any time in the mountains or anything, you know you love this, you like this painting. But anyways, guys, this is the fucking projector. I got it hooked up S-video to the fucking inverter. So we'll come back to it here when I have it all set up. Well, I couldn't get the fucking wireless controller to work, but guys, look at this fucking shit right here. I'm actually about to fucking play Mario. This is the first time I busted out this Nintendo, and the first time I busted out this projector. I'm sitting here getting high with the dogs, guys, in the fucking kitchen. This shit right here is awesome, because I was a middle child and I never got my own shit, guys. I never got to fucking play video games, you know? The firstborn always gets the new shit, and then the baby always gets shit too, guys. And so when you're a middle kid, you don't ever get your own shit, man. And that's why I'm always gonna be a kid for life, guys. Anyways. Who wants a hit? Who wants a shotgun? I just hooked up the audio. I gotta play with the cord behind me, but let's see. The Super C. This shit's pretty awesome.
Yeah, this fucking Guinness goes hard, dude. Oh, I'm gonna fucking smoke and fucking play this shit out of this. Alright, see you guys later.
I just wanted to say I'm really sorry, guys. I've been fucking jacking off compulsively, guys, and that's why I haven't been uploading the video, guys. That's just going to be me being truthful. I know I opened up with that a stupid comment, but that's how detrimental masturbating can be sometimes. Anyways, I just wanted to show you this fucking badass dually. Guys, I've never seen an old-school Dodge Ram dually like this. This is just a really nice old specimen, so I just wanted to take a picture of it, guys. Isn't that fucking nice? You know, guys, the whole masturbating guys thing, like, guys, get over it, you know, like, boo-hoo, you know, like, I can't fucking help it that I just love myself so much, you know what I'm saying?
Good thing I'm fucking getting off of work right now. Look at this shit, guys. This time I have sex, that's how it's gonna be.
A homicide scene right here, guys. Somebody killed this bee. Got a dead bee. Had a dead bee. You gonna come up here? Come on. Get up here, Cobra. Get up here, Cobra. Come on, Bingo, your turn. Can he do it? Can he do it? Oh my God, he figured out a trick where he doesn't have to get up there. Bingo made himself taller. I don't know how you got taller all of a sudden, Bingo, but I need to try that. Also, I was moving all the rocks. I moved all the rocks from the front. Just some rocks that were close to the front of the street. And I just placed them right here. I think they look a lot better. What do you guys think? Get the fuck out of there. And I don't want to be mean to the dogs. But I just want them to realize that when they see a barrier like this here, that they just need to stay out of it. And that worked, didn't it? Now, Bingo will probably work his way back in there, but with enough reminding, he'll make it a habit of staying out of it. I'm gonna show you guys what I drew up last night while I was at work. That's Cobra. He's been out there for like an hour. And, watch this. I was just gonna jingle the doorbell. He's such a good boy. This glass is so dirty from the dogs licking it. I always have to clean it, but. Hey, Cobra, you wanna come in? You wanna come in? I think he wants to come in. Okay. Now I had another drawing that I had kind of just drawn up, a design for the pool. But the designs are always changing, so I can't find it. Maybe someone threw it away. I'll have to check. But initially, I always liked a rectangular pool. This incorporates the house next door also. So this is the house next door and the garage. The scale is a little off. This one's more precise. I worked on this last night while I was at work. This is what I wanted to show you guys. Now this design is what I really like. So this concept here is more like a natural pool. I'm gonna try to just not deal with the hassle of a chlorine pool, but it's not gonna be like a muddy mess. It's still gonna be all like grout, and it's all going to be like plastered cement. But I'll just walk you through like the concept that I have here. This is the house actually right here, and this is a patio covering design that I didn't come up with. I saw it incorporated into a buddy's dad's house that I spent a lot of time at a few years back, and so I just studied the carpentry on the house and the fence, and I just always made a mental note of everything, and I really liked the design. Their patio had like this is all covered, you know, so you could be sitting under it while it's raining and you're not gonna get wet. And then here's like some lattice work where it does allow rainfall and light, or you can make it to where it just allows light. The reason why is because there's windows here in this kitchen. And then I also opted to do the same, but more open, and probably have this design here, because it looks very busy. And I don't really want it so thick. But here, this is the AC unit of the house, and then here's where it meets the corner. So the house cuts in a little bit. Forgive my smashed finger. I smashed it. That's why it looks like that. Anyways. And so implementing a curved patio like this complements a curved pool, you know, because I was thinking like square house, square shed, square lot, just to do a square pool. But I wouldn't really be able to get the length that I wanted to do a lap pool. Now, that's not gonna, I'm thinking this might be like 33 feet long ways right here. But I need to go out with the wheel and really measure everything. But I'll just walk you through the design of it. You can copy it if you want or whatever. But so this incorporates everything. Like this is the north side of the house, the drive that goes all the way to the backyard. And so I wanted to like cut it off so it meshes in with the grass. These are trees. This is like where the water fountain is for the dogs. And then this is that green tree that we started off the channel with right there. And then this could probably go, it could probably turn into like a little pool where I keep all the equipment, you know, I don't know. And then this is the shed that you see here, guys, and then normally the Jeep is right here. So anyways, this is the pool design. I wanted it to be like, as soon as when you walk out of the house, I wanted to be able to just dive in and swim, you know, like wake up that way I like to start off my day like that, guys. So that's the idea behind this, is just swim here. And then and originally I was thinking like it would be like a chlorinated pool, right? And I would just do the shallow ends here. This would be like a 3 feet, this would be 6 feet, and then it would get like 7, 8, and then 10 feet at the deepest. I wanted to go higher, but I just think there's no point, you know, 10 feet is substantial. And then you know, I wanted to do like a reef here, guys, to like where you could the dogs could lay, you could put a lounge there. And then the entryway would just be like you know, one or two steps, and then it would just go 1, 2, 3, 4, and so on. You get the idea. And I would incorporate some steps here, like some ledging, so you could hang out here and also right here. And so that's the design, guys. And then this area here, I should really get a pen so you guys don't have to look at my fucking fingers all the time. So like this area here, this is going to be like the regeneration zone for like the pool. Since this pool's not gonna be chlorinated, it's gonna have like a bunch of gravel and stuff right here. And then just like maybe some bamboo, a couple plants of bamboo, and then you know, some other light vegetation, and some freshwater mussels. I hear that those are really good. I've been really consuming a shit ton of YouTube lately. And that's why I haven't fucking uploaded or edited anything. Anyway, so that's that area right there. Apparently you want like a 20% of the pool. I know this is not even that much, but you know, it could be. We could just grow this area larger. And so ideally you wouldn't want this portion here would be above the water level that you would be swimming in here. And so the pool would filter out this area here. I'm really stoned right now. This area here and this area here would filter out the pool, guys. That's pretty much what it is. There would be like vegetation in here that would, since there's no gravel in here, since all there would be in here would be rocks and gravel, that doesn't provide enough nutrients for plants to grow and thrive on, right? So the plants would get their nutrition and all the microbes from the water in here, guys. The microbes would let me get my understanding. The microbes and all the organisms would be able to multiply and feed the plants and keep the water clean. That's my understanding. I understand it very well in my head, so I may not be able to explain it to you guys. But yeah, and then this is right where I was digging, where I was taking all that vegetation out, guys. So you see this boulder mound. It's really gonna be like a boulder mound. I may even have to make my own boulders, which is totally fine. I'm actually looking forward to it if I do get this far into the project. And then, I wanted to show you guys before I go out there and kind of show you the layout, so you can kind of get a picture for it. But yeah, this ideally would all be paved brick that I'm going to make my own. I already bought a mold. I'm going to make my own pavers for it. And then I would leave a little cutout circular area there for that tree that we have growing there, or other trees that would go there in the future or whatever. And yeah, so all this area here by the fence. Oh man, that was my dad that walked in. Anyways, guys, we'll talk more about those designs later. I was asking him if he threw away a design in here that I had. This is just something I drew at work yesterday, guys. And I need to get some actual grid paper to work on. And this is just some pens that I had that I wasn't able to find like green or anything. So that's just why it is the way it is right there, guys. But let me show you something else. All this vinegar right here, guys. I'm gonna dump this. I'll show you what I'm doing with that here in a second. But I'm not painting in this video. Obviously, this video is way too long, but I did want to show you the paint machine that I bought because I mentioned it earlier in the video, and I just felt like if some of you guys were interested, this is what I bought. And so anything comparable to this at Home Depot would have been well over $200. So if you're in the market for a paint machine, fuck, look at this one, you know, $80, guys. I haven't seen any reviews. I looked at for a review or a video on YouTube. I didn't find any. I went ahead and pulled the trigger on it. But I will go ahead and make a review on it once I do get ready to paint the house. Why not, right? Fuck it. So I just wanted to show you that. This is the fucking grass seed that I've got. I did a lot of research. Who fucking calls it research, guys? I just read a lot of reviews, and supposedly this is a really good grass seed. So that's just what I wanted to show you guys. That's what I'm gonna thicken up the lawn with. Also, guys, you know I told you that this walkway here, I'm gonna be using this. I'm sure you guys have seen a lot of videos of people using these walkways. This one's yellow. I was expecting it to be black, but I guess, you know, maybe this is a more reinforced version. I actually bought a second mold, guys, because I thought it would be easier to have two molds to go quicker. And while that is true, I'll tell you what I'm going to do, because I am implementing this as a driveway application. I'm going to take the second mold because I feel like 2 inches isn't thick enough, or maybe it's thick enough to drive a truck on and stuff, guys. But I don't want to fucking worry about it, guys. So this is what I'm going to do, guys. I'll make a video specific or probably a series of whenever I do make the fucking driveway. Because the whole driveway is going to be this paved, this style right here, guys. If you can imagine, all of this is going to be like that. All of it. So it's going to take me quite a while. But don't worry, because my dad actually has a cement mixing machine, so it's no problem. But the reason why I got two, and I'm happy I got two, is because, as you see, the slits go all the way, guys. So when you pull this off, each stone is by itself, you know? So you see you have some people that have grass grow through it. I'm not going to have that. I don't like that look. I'm going to put sand in there, polymeric sand, or, you know, most likely that's what I'm going to do, guys. But I'm not even going to fucking need it, guys. I'm just going to put it in there so that it's flush. Because I hate going on these fucking, stepping on these things, because they're still going, your feet are still going to rock in between those cracks. And I don't like that. So this is what I'm going to do, guys. I got the other one coming. And I'm going to, like, plastic weld it on there, or JB weld it, or just tape it, or whatever, guys. I'm going to get the other one on there. But I'm going to cut out the middle, guys. Everything. I'm only going to keep the perimeter, guys, on the new one. Now, that's an option, and that's why I'm doing that, so that I can make them really thick, guys. And so if you can imagine a whole nother one of these under it, it's only when you pull it up, it's only gonna leave the crack for like the 2 inches, the first 2 inches, and then the bottom 2 inches, guys, is all going to be solid, and that means it's all going to be one piece, guys. And so 4 inches of good concrete with a lot of aggregate and rock is going to be fucking strong, guys. And that's really going to be the only way I'm able to make a quality, substantial driveway, guys. Because all you see everybody else that makes these, guys, just stay tuned, guys. What I'm saying may not make sense. And another idea that I did have was just to put this in the ground, you know, like place it in the ground where I'm gonna leave it, guys, and then like spray paint the outline or whatever, take it out, and then dig down like 3 inches, so that when I do pour in the cement, shovel the cement, it has a bigger cavity in under it, guys. So that's actually an option that I can do, and I can still just run two molds consecutively or simultaneously, so that I could get done quicker. But yeah, so that's just an idea for you guys, because you don't always have to just go with the thickness that the mold is there for, you know. Sometimes they may even just ship it like this, because it's more economical for them, you know. Maybe, I'm sure I'm not the fucking first person to think that it's better to just dig deeper so that when you pull it out, you just have one piece. So I'm sure I'm not the first one. Now, guys, these are other molds that I got. And I got these on Amazon, and it was like close to $70 for a 6-piece. But I'll check these out. The texture on these is just amazing, and they really are supposed to leave really amazing fucking results, guys. Look at this shit. And so what you could do, actually, if you wanted to, is you could just like shovel a big mound of concrete, like a big, like say you got a big turd of good concrete on the ground, and then you just take this mold and then you just smash it on top, and then you just put like a bucket or something on top of it to hold it down, and then, you know, maybe in a couple of days you lift it up, and then, you know, you got a rock with a big fucking fat belly in the ground, like an iceberg, if you can imagine what I'm saying. But that's just if you're worried about the thickness. If you're not worried about the thickness is really okay, as long as you have a good base. So I'm planning on using these in here, guys, but not all over, because I have another mold coming that I'm gonna incorporate with this. Yeah, I have another mold that I'm either going to do. One mold is going to be the border, and one mold is going to be for the inside. So I'm waiting on the other mold. I don't know which one I'm going to do. But as far as this and the front of the house, guys, that's all going to be done with the Quick Creek Wok Maker. And here, guys, on the porch, this fucking cement mixing machine has just been sitting here. And so, you know, I'll just relocate it to the backyard, guys. So you know what I'm saying? It's definitely going to happen. All this right here is going to be done with the Quick Creek Wok Maker. I'm going to figure out some sort of... Well, I'm going to install plastic edging for sure. I'm not even worried about it, guys. I'm just going to do the Quick Creek Wok Maker, kind of like follow it along there, all along the house. It's gonna look nice, guys. See, the benefit to having so many fucking things going on in the works, guys, I have so many projects going on, and all that just pulls me forward into the future, guys. All that shit keeps me out of the bars. It just keeps me focused on the big plan, guys. And that's why I live here with my parents, guys, because I'm going to inherit this house sooner or later, you know? And so wouldn't it just make sense to just dump all my money and to spend as much time here with my family as possible, guys? If this is going to be my home, why not just turn it into my dream home? You know? You know what I'm saying, guys? So that later on in life, I don't have to fucking do any of this shit. I don't know. It's just some food for thought, guys. If you find yourself living with your parents, you know, that's a good thing, guys. You know, if you're living at home with your parents and you think about moving out, or you're getting guilted by a partner or somebody or your friends for shaming you for living with your parents, guys, you can learn so much from your parents. I mean, they're surviving on this planet, guys. You know how many fucking people can't hold it together, guys? You know, the prisons and the cemeteries are full of people, guys, that couldn't fucking control it, couldn't hack it. So yeah, guys, life is nothing but seasons, guys. You know, there's a season for sowing and a season for reaping. And if you gotta fucking sow for 10, 15 years, you know, that's good. That's just proof that you're gonna be reaping some amazing rewards later on in life. And that's the way I look at it, guys. You know, do I wanna fucking do all these little things here? Do I wanna dump my money into my parents' house? No, I fucking don't, right? I'm a single guy, guys. I would love to just, you know, fill up my backpack. I got a passport ready, guys. I got all sorts of sporting equipment, guys. I have all sorts of knowledge. I could go out into the world and survive, but I don't want to, guys. I'd rather just stay here and take care of what needs to be done. You know, staycations, they're a thing now, guys. I think traveling, that's really like, that was a pre-COVID thing now, guys. After the pandemic, and just with so many fucking leadership and so many countries going out of control, guys, no one trusts nobody anymore. And so it all really depends on how big your family is. If you have a big family structure, you can afford to travel more. But if you have a smaller knit family, the best thing to do is just to stay home and watch out for your things, man, because once you fucking leave, guys, there's always somebody looking to encroach on you. Life is always a fight for territory. Don't forget that. That goes for staying in shape, that goes for keeping your job, that goes for keeping your lover happy, everything, guys. Anyways, cocaine drop, guys. I was gonna show y'all something, but I gotta go pick up this drop. Just kidding. Did I tell y'all about my childhood best friend that I had, guys, who managed to graduate with a bachelor's in economics only to throw it all away in less than a year because He couldn't just fucking stay away from drugs, guys, from dealing drugs. His dad, that's actually the man who had the backyard oasis that I want to implement back here. You know, seeing his father, who's a Vietnam veteran, and also like an entrepreneur of many sorts, seeing him, how he managed his life after his divorce, because he was a baby boomer, that guy, right? And so seeing him after he managed it, he thrived after the divorce. I remember his ex-wife, you know, she came down with cancer, some sort of cancer, I'm not sure what kind. And, you know, and then he started up other businesses and slept with a plethora of women. And, you know, how can you judge a man? You just can't judge anyone in life. The older you get, you just realize that you don't really fucking have any time to judge. If you were judging, and we're all guilty of it, we just have to correct ourselves. But if you wallow in judgment, keyword wallow in it, you fucking neglecting your life and what you need to take care of. But yeah, that's what another thing of morality, you know, divorce, you know, till death do you part. You know, some people fucking take that shit literal, you know, and are they wrong? You know, I don't know, guys. I tell you guys all the fucking time, I don't know anything. I don't know anything. I don't even know how we got to talking about this, guys. The dogs are over here looking at me like, hey, what's wrong with our food? There's something missing. Yeah, I forgot to add the wet food. And I will, guys. But before I get too high, yeah, all this vinegar, guys. All this vinegar is so I could clean all these tools out. I have been like just little buckets of tools that I've been neglecting and leaving around, and they just get rusted, guys. And the best way to clean them, guys, is to just let them soak in vinegar and then take a wire brush. So in the next video, guys, when you tune in, all these tools will be clean along with more tools that I find. I'll go ahead and throw them in here as I fill up these containers. And I'm also going to clean up my own tools. And why I want to clean my tools really good is because I'm going to invest in a proper tool bag so I can store my shit, so I can get them out of that tote. That tote just gets water in it all the time. Hey guys, last time you saw me get some bags, right? I put some bags right here, guys. Well, guess what? I fucking went and got more bags. Right? These are all white marble chips. They're really pretty rocks. Pretty. I don't really use that word, but when we're talking about rocks, guys, we'll fucking use that word. These are nice, pretty rocks. Let's see. I think there's an open bag here. And you can't find these rocks online, actually. So these are really at our store. So I'm really taking advantage of them. I don't know if you can see, but I'm going to use these for landscaping around the house. I'm also going to use these as a layer of top exposed aggregate on these concrete slabs that I'm going to use. I know you guys have seen like the 3x5 slabs. I don't know if that's the correct measurement. But you guys have seen like here are more rocks, right? These are all more rocks. These are half the price of the white marble rocks. And believe it or not, guys, I brought all these rocks in the Honda Accord. Took me 12 bags a trip. And every trip I bought 12 bags. So there's not too many trips so far, guys. So I have been buying a lot of rocks. And I have been making decisions on what kind of tile I'm going to put in the pool. And what kind of tile and backsplashes and stuff I'm going to add to the house. So I have actually been quite very busy, guys. Very, very busy indeed. But you see this is a 2-foot square paver. And so I'm going to make my own pavers, like big ass pavers, guys. I'm not talking about the mold that I mentioned. These are just, I want to make like big 3x5 molds. And then I want to have like that white marble exposed, guys, on top of the concrete. Let me just see, let me grab the rock so you can get an idea.
So obviously you have to clean the rock before you, really good before you put it in cement. And it's still nice and white. It's still nice and white. But as you see, once I'm gonna build my own big slabs, I'm gonna put some of that aggregate in down in the mix. But once I am ready to trowel it off at the top, I'm gonna plunge a bunch of this onto the top, guys. And then I'm going to keep troweling it until it all, until all of it's going to be covered 100%, but I'm going to finish troweling it to where it's to where the rocks are just under the surface. And then as the concrete starts to get really hard harder, I'm going to slowly take a broom, a fine brush, and just gently with the water hose expose the top layer of all this rock, guys. So there's just going to be a bunch of pavers with the white rock. And then, you know, once maybe like after a month and it's fully cured, then I'll go ahead and like seal them with some sort of sealer, guys. But yeah, isn't that, can you imagine what that will look like? It would just look amazing, guys. So I'm gonna do like 3x5 going out to here. And then I wish I would have brought the paper out here. Well, I'll just get it. So you see like right here, guys, we're going out the back door. I want to have like big slabs of this stuff following down, right? And then like also like kind of like a pyramid, like a reverse arrow opening into the pool, and then the pool's going to have other tiles. So that's the way I'm going to incorporate like a bunch of different tiles in here into the backyard, guys. So I have a lot of ideas, guys. I've been really busy. I'm really sorry I didn't put out any new videos while I was recording material, but I have just been really busy doing a lot of thinking. I know that sounds kind of fucking stupid, right? But it's actually harder than you think to think. So think about that. So I just wanted to show you guys, this is the it's not drawn to scale, but you get the idea. All this right here is going to be covered with this porch. So right now we would be under the porch. And we're walking right along this tree right here. That would be this little area. So you guys can see. Can you guys see? We're right here. The house is behind us. The fence is actually closer to us. But let's just go ahead and take a dive into the pool real quick, guys. So maybe 1 meter in, and we're in the pool, guys. So right now we're in the fucking pool. And actually the regeneration area is on either side, is on both sides of us. So right now we have a full channel right here where we have a 6 foot deep, as soon as we jump in right here, 6 foot deep, and it goes all the way gradual to 7, 8, 10. Oh guys, I think we definitely have a lot of room here, guys. We definitely have a lot of room. So this would just be my swim lane right here, guys. And then yeah, this is amazing. Well, I don't know, because of the setback in the fence, so I'm gonna have to alter the design. But maybe the boulder, maybe we could just do, maybe this is how it's going to be. The boulder, the big boulder waterfall is going to be right here, guys, in this area. Yeah, I'm gonna have to tweak the design a little bit, but that's just all part of it, guys. It's actually much easier now that I drew that out. So what I was thinking was, we still have plenty of room right here to bow out the pool, and then we can just tile over this existing pavement. And then all this right here
Remember, guys, I was telling y'all about the reef. Yeah, let me grab the paper. So you guys see how I have the boulder waterfall back there? Let me go back, guys. I'm really high, but we can still make this work. I mean, what's this YouTube, guys? You don't have to watch this if you don't want to. All right, so we are directly left of this little circle right here, guys. So ideally right now we would be coming in right into the pool, because I'd like to, you know, you gotta walk back here. We're gonna have a big gate, but you walk back here, and I want to be able to take advantage of this free area right here, right, to start the pool, right, so that we can get as much length out of it as possible. So I'm thinking that would be right here. That would probably be like 4 feet from where the end of the, what do you call that, the covered patio would be. Okay, guys, back to the reef. Let's say this is the edge of the pool. Yeah, this looks more promising. See where we're at, guys? We got plenty of room. Okay, so we're gonna walk in right now to the reef. So right now we can walk into a couple steps. It's either gonna be a couple steps or just, you know, a gradual descent, either or, you know, it doesn't matter. But then definitely have a shallow area here for the dogs, a platform of a sort. And then all right here, guys, is where the trees are. So all this we could take advantage of for lounging, for deck space. All plenty of good usable water. So all this right here is this shallow cove beach area that, you know, my parents and little kids and dogs can utilize. And then this deep channel is for the swimmers. And then you want it deep, because any swimmer likes to just go down to the deep end and hold their breath and sit at the bottom and look up. And the deeper, the more magical it is, the swimming experience. So I just wanted to say, you know, if you're gonna fucking dig a deep pool, what's the difference between 10 and 12 feet, you know? But how much difference in those 2 feet? But just a cool fact, you could do scuba certifications in pools that are at least 14 feet deep. So is it worth it? It might be worth it to go a little bit deeper. If we can go deeper, I wouldn't mind going 14 feet deep. I mean, that would just be fucking amazing. Even if it's only 14 feet for like a 3 foot radius, that's still pretty cool, you know? But I think 10 feet, 12 feet, that's okay. So right now we're still in the channel. You know, and the only thing really to worry about is how close do you get to excavation when you're fucking around with these trees. I don't know how far these trees, the roots go. I think the rule of thumb is a couple feet out from under the canopy is where the roots would stop. So like probably where my feet are right now is still where the roots come out. But it doesn't matter. If we're excavating for the pool, we'll just chop off those fucking roots. And if we're really talking, if it's between the pool or the tree, that tree can grow, because we have plenty of outside perimeter trees. So that's really no problem for me. This tree's no problem. So yeah, the only thing is how far back can we go in here? We definitely don't want to disturb this tree, and we like that tree. All this area right here can be utilized as deck space, so that's great. Don't pay any attention to this. Imagine all this gone. It will be gone. So the guys, this is what I wanted to show y'all. This is a trick. We're gonna do is I'm gonna pour water on this piece of paper. And then tomorrow, we should have our fucking pool. That's how it works, guys. I don't know where you, what country you live in, but here in America, you just draw it on paper, and then you go to sleep, and then you come back the next day, and then somehow, miraculously, guys, it all comes together. So I just wanted to show you that.
You got any cool ideas or suggestions for the pool or what you would like to see? Go ahead and comment below. You know, nobody ever comments on these videos, so I don't even know if I should continue to make them. But if you want to comment, you want to say hello, you want to talk shit, you can. It's all is welcome. Everyone is welcomed. Have a great day.